office wanted to bring substantive visibility for Africa into Africa Day. The theme of the ADS was oriented to follow that of the African Union's theme of the year and to also coincide with the celebrations of Africa Day held on 25th May each year. The goal of doing so was to bring about concrete or action-oriented recommendations and UN coherent support based on Africa's own priorities. Today, the Africa Dialogue series continues on that legacy to showcase African richness and best practices and to amplify African voices, including those of Africa's most valuable assets, our young people. I wish to thank my successor, USD Duarte, for believing in the value of the ADS and continue where I left off. My own participation today from Namibia to launch the youth conversation is a clear testimony. The ADS is a platform for listening to Africa's youth and for the youth to take their rightful place as key voices in policy discussions. As part of OSA's programs, I always emphasize the need for youth core leadership and active participation. And we ensured that since the first series, that youth was provided with that space. This year's edition of the ADS focuses on cultural identity and ownership, reshaping mindsets, a theme inspired on the AU theme of the year, which is arts, culture, and heritage, levers for building the Africa that we want. Indeed, art, culture, and heritage are powerful tools for taking ownership of our present and future and building the Africa of tomorrow based on a strong cultural identity of all of us as Africans. Culture and identity were two of the most powerful instruments that we had to fight for our freedom and defeat colonialism, apartheid, and occupation. African historians would remind us of our glorious past, of our struggle, and of independence. African singers would keep up the spirits with their songs' lyrics, encouraging us to continue fighting. African artists would depict what a post-colonial Africa would look like. Today, through art, culture, and heritage, we rediscover ourselves, we establish our true identities as Africans, and promote a change in mindsets that is needed in order to promote a new narrative for Africa and from Africa. This is why it is key to take the opportunity that the ADS provides to pass on the baton to Africa's youth, to tell Africa's stories, bring in Africa's richness, culture, and norms, to foster practical approaches and holistic thinking to modern day challenges, drawing on the wisdom of our ancestors. Young people need to be at the driver's seat for Africa to achieve social justice, peace, and environmental sustainability. Their ingenuity, untainted by past fears and failures, can transform the continent through innovation, science, and technology, particularly in areas of public service delivery, breaking down stale and bureaucratic legacies to bring about the Africa we want. If Africans could build pyramids, temples, and palaces, and heal ourselves through our traditional medicines, keeping livelihoods through our knowledge of nature, coexist with our natural environments long before colonialism invaded Africa, why can we not think of ourselves as people who must learn from others, but most importantly, as people who have the indigenous knowledge systems to teach and impart? Now is the time for the youth to take the stage on the Africa Dialogue series. Let the youth conversation start, and wishing you all the best.